Welcome to the Innovation Coffee Break. My name is Gregor Hordys, and I will talk about connectivity. Many automotive applications today use connectivity. It will be even more in the future. Connectivity enables many infotainment functions, helping improving comfort and efficiency. Today, I will concentrate on use cases related to safety and ADAS AD. I'd like to show you some milestones of V2X development towards connected automated vehicle. I will outline the need for advanced HIL simulation, and I will briefly present to you a new dSPACE V2X solution. So let's have a quick look on evolution of V2X and some challenges for testing. First, cars equipped with V2X are already on the roads. We speak about day one applications or awareness driving. It is about sharing status data, such as position or speed between vehicles. This information is used, for example, to calculate trajectories and to warn the driver about hazards around the corner. Requirements on simulation and testing of awareness driving are moderate. Vehicle status data and position data must be provided to the device under test in a synchronized way. The next major step, called collective perception, will enable vehicles and infrastructure, such as cameras on intersections, to provide sensor data as object lists, and later with 5G also as raw sensor data to other vehicles. This information will be integrated with functions for perception and data fusion. Testing of collective perception will need realistic sensor simulation and more detailed environment simulation with support of infrastructure. A further step, called cooperative driving, vehicles will be able to share their driving intentions. And thanks to 5G, even to coordinate maneuvers with other cars and infrastructure in real time. This kind of applications will require integration with vehicles for maneuver planning and decision making. Validation of functions for cooperative driving will need to handle a lot of scenarios with high number of vehicles, which will require a tailored concept for scenario and test development, such as scenario-based testing, as well as a large-scale simulation. As you see, from milestone to milestone, we will get an increasing number and complexity of scenarios and increasing demand for simulation and validation on HIL. I believe that the key factor for successful testing of advanced V2X applications and connected automated driving will be in a right combination of an ADAS AD capable HIL system and a flexible simulator for V2X communication. Let me show this on a concrete example. The new dSPACE V2X solution for HIL is an integration of Wave Behive V2X simulator with Scalexio HIL. The V2X simulator provided by our cooperation partner NORDSYS consists of a V2X simulation server and radio transceivers for device-to-device communication based on 11P or LTE V2X. The V2X simulation server supports relevant standards in Europe, US, and China. The system is equipped with a so-called V2X multi-stack that allows to use a high number of simulated communication stations, such as vehicles or roadside units, with many fuel V2X stacks running in parallel. This makes the solution scalable and fit for advanced scenarios like cooperative driving. For early development of applications for collective perception, a draft implementation of collective perception message is also included. The V2X simulator allows secured and unsecured communication and can be expanded by a dynamic channel attenuation, which enables testing under more realistic channel conditions, such as simulation of channel load. For integration with Wave Behive, dSPACE provides a V2X interface block set, based on standardized V2X application protocols to easily integrate with new or existing HIL test environments. The ASM tool suite can provide sensor simulation with different sensor types and different levels of detail to support collective perception as well as high number of fellow vehicles for cooperative driving. The solution is complemented by a seamless integration of V2X with ASM model desk to enable infrastructure simulation, which allows provision of intersection topology or traffic light status from the model in order to generate complex map and SPAD messages for V2X communication without expert knowledge. And finally, the sensor-based testing provided by dSPACE can additionally accelerate test development and help to reduce the workload. Just a few words on the use case before shifting to the live demonstration. The demonstration shows the advanced intersection collision warning, which is based on collective perception. We use a traffic radar, which is mounted in the lower left corner of the intersection, with a wide opening angle to have a look at the whole crossing. The actors in this use case are the roadside unit, equipped with the radar sensor, a cyclist, a truck, and our vehicle under test in blue on the right-hand side. The cyclist is behind the truck. He is not visible to the blue car, but is approaching the intersection and will turn to the left. In this situation, the driver usually has a poor chance to see a cyclist and to stop in time. However, in our use case, the traffic radar recognizes the cyclist approaching the intersection and provides this information as object list via collective perception message. The vehicle under test receives the CPM and, based on sensor information, calculates a possible collision trajectory. A warning about a dangerous situation is shown to the driver. Now let me shift to the live demonstration. So, this is our simulation system. As mentioned before, it consists of two parts. What you see on the bottom is our Scalexio HIL simulator, and here the second part is the NORDSYS V2X simulation system, which consists of a simulation server and the radio transceiver part. So what you also can see here is a ECU. This is our device under test. This could be in the future the device under test of our customers. And the device under test is connected on the one side to the Scalexio system via CAN bus, and on the other side we have a connection over the air connection here between the device under test and the NORDSYS simulator. And this is an 11P based communication. So we have a small application on the device under test, and the information about CPM, as mentioned before, which comes from the HIL simulation from our sensor simulation, is provided here via the V2X simulator to the device under test. And the small application on the device under test shows if there is a collision, or a possible collision between the participants, and in case of this collision risk, this information is sent to the driver and showed on the display. So let me go to our simulation system, to our monitors. On the left monitor, you can see the WaveBeTouch software, which is provided by NORDSYS. The WaveBeTouch is a map-based software which can show you the V2X messages which are currently in the air. And on the right-hand side, we have our demonstration, which is shown in the motion desk 3D visualization tool, as I mentioned before. So I will start now the live demo. I have to switch to control desk, and I'll start the test. So now you can see in motion desk, this scenario has been started. Our car is approaching the intersection on the left-hand side. The track is also approaching the intersection. Now you can see also the cyclist, and on the right-hand side, the warning. As you have seen, the collective perception message helps to avoid risky situations and can save lives. So thank you for your interest. See you next time. Goodbye.
dSPACE, your partner in simulation and validation.